Hello everyone and welcome. As every month, we are here to provide you with an overview of the latest news about Sales Copilot with me, Amira, and my colleague Corina. We have recently transitioned to the name Sales Copilot, and while our new identity is taking shape, please note that some logos are still in the process of being updated in certain experiences. Well, now let's dive into the updates and the exciting developments we have in store for you today. So let's start with a brief timeline to clarify things. Last year in October 2022, we introduced Microsoft Viva Sales, an AI-focused solution aimed at enhancing the productivity of salespeople in their workflow. Following that, in March, we announced Microsoft 365 Copilot. And today we are excited to announce the relaunch of Viva Sales as Microsoft Sales Copilot, an assistant solution for salespeople that integrates with the Microsoft 365 and your CRM. Sales Copilot boosts seller productivity by streamlining AI-based insights, customized prompts, and workflows into Microsoft 365 and Dynamics 365. This integration optimizes customer interaction and deal closer speed, while also connecting to diverse CRM systems to automate data management and prioritize selling time. In this video today, we will focus on the latest updates around Sales Copilot experience with Microsoft 365 and your CRM. So our presentation will be divided into three sections, focusing on the recent updates of July and August 2023. Firstly, how Sales Copilot enhances sales productivity. Secondly, how it personalizes customer interactions with real-time tips and suggestions. And finally, how all these enables sellers to maintain their workflow seamlessly with data access across Microsoft 365 apps and your CRM. So let's start by the unlock sales productivity section. The July update of Sales Copilot introduces language support for email summaries in French, Spanish, and German. Additionally, this update includes quality enhancements, including specialized treatment for brief emails. So I highly recommend you to test this in different languages and provide us your feedback. The second point is that sellers now have access to the tone knob feature that allows them to choose between formal and informal emails style for the generated suggestions. Additionally, there is an enhanced user interface design to improve the overall seller experience. So here it's a very important feature for sellers in order to specially adjust the tone with their customers, whether it's formal email, friendly one, or just a professional email, for example. Third feature we have here is the real-time tips in Teams meeting side panel. So the real-time information cards are triggered within the Sales Copilot Teams panel when customers mention a competitor or brand, for example. So these cards help sellers to address the objections, demonstrate knowledge, and appear well prepared for the meeting by knowing more about competitors and the different brands, for example. This feature is now in preview, so to join, please reach out by completing the form that you can see here in this slide. Let's now pass to the server-side sync once saving the emails and pointing to Dynamics 365. So with this recent release, we aim to highlight the importance of enabling server-side sync for Sales Copilot. So this feature brings several benefits to Sales Copilot users, including ensuring a uniform save and unsave status visibility for all participants, and enabling the removal of saved emails from Sales Copilot within Dynamics 365, and finally automating the saver replies in email threads that are already stored in the CRM. So you don't need to save them in the CRM each time you receive a new email for in the same thread. And here it's a news for Salesforce customers. So when you save an email to Salesforce CRM, if the character count in the Outlook email body exceeds the maximum limit allowable by Salesforce email records, the email is truncated before being saved. So a notification is presented in the connected to the card, informing you about the truncation of the email. And this is very helpful for sellers because before they used to receive an error message, and here, so it's just a notification to let you know that this will be truncated automatically and you can proceed with the saving the email in the CRM. Update email summary. So this is a very important one for sellers around the email summarizer. So integrating, which aim on integrating transparency features and providing summaries with the citations into AI systems. to cultivate a sense of responsibility, transparency, and accountability. So with this release, we have enhanced the email summaries by including citations and clear insights, which serve as a valuable reference for end users. So if you see something in the summary or in the email suggestions, you can see from where this information comes. Also, in the same context, with the suggested email content, sellers often face the task of generating new prompts for each email, leading to inefficiencies and inconsistent messages. So to address this, Sales Copilot allows now sellers to save, reuse, and delete their custom prompts. So for example, if you use a prompt today, you can just put it in your favorite prompts and reuse it tomorrow. And if you don't need it anymore or you don't use it anymore, you can simply delete it in order to not see it in the list anymore. Let's now pass to the last feature covered in this section concerning the meeting invitations. So it's a great news for several customers because it has been requested many, many times. Automated meeting suggestions are no longer in effect. In fact, with this, previously, for all the email replies, there were always meeting invitation suggestions at the end. And sometimes the seller doesn't really want to suggest a meeting. He just wants to answer the email. So now, starting the August release, meeting invitation suggestions will be included exclusively when a meeting intent is identified, whether in a slide by the customer or by the seller. Furthermore, sellers can now fine-tune the drafts and request meeting invitation suggestions. So as you can see here in the screen, at the end of the screen, there is a suggested meeting time, and the seller can select it and update the email suggestion. This was the last point in this section. I will hand it over to my colleague Corina now to present to you the latest update with the next two sections.
Thank you, Amira, and hello, everyone. Let's continue with the features that were released in July and August that provide AI assistance to sellers so that they can personalize their customer interactions and ultimately close deals faster, starting with an improved Teams meeting experience. So for a meeting, you would have tracked your CRM system. When you start a meeting, you can now view and edit the connected CRM record linked to that particular meeting. If that connected CRM record is an opportunity, you will observe the opportunity summary card displayed on the highlights tab, showing you the key details and status all within the meeting context. There is also the CRM link for the connected record that's easily accessible so that you can open that particular record in your CRM system in the browser to view its complete details. You can use that link as well in a Teams chat or an email message. And you might be well aware of this today that if you paste the link to a Teams chat, it will get inferred into a rich adaptive card provided you have installed the Sales Copilot app in Teams. So overall, with this improved CRM experience in Teams, you can run meetings and also keep your CRM records fresh as the conversation unfolds. Next, we have improved the accessibility of opportunity summaries. You might be already familiar with the opportunity summaries, which generate the concise customer brief that the sellers can use to quickly ramp up and ensure they're prepared for every meeting. Now, we are improving the accessibility of opportunity summaries, and you can now access these as well when reading an email. We're also improving the transparency of the summaries by adding explanations with data references in the UI, just like we do already today for the generated email reply. The opportunity summary is displayed in the context of an email only if that email has been saved to the CRM system and it's connected to an opportunity. The summary shown in the context of a meeting can also be generated based on the most relevant opportunity that was selected by AI, if that meeting is not already connected to an opportunity. Next, let's discuss the features that have been released recently that allow sellers to be their most productive by having access to CRM data seamlessly in their flow of work. So starting with what's new for the auto-signing experience, sellers of Dynamics 365 that have access to multiple environments will be automatically signed in from the Sales Copilot Outlook add-in. Basically, when launching Sales Copilot in Outlook for the first time, the Highlights tab will be shown, skipping the sign-in steps and instead seeing Switch Environments dialog. The rules of auto-sign-in are the next. Users that have access to a single environment or single production environment with the Sales Copilot solution installed will be auto-signed in, and we'll see an enhanced dismissible message bar. This was available already. What comes new with the latest release is that users that have access to multiple production or multiple sandbox environments will also be signed in, and we'll see a dialogue with an environment switcher, basically allowing them to switch environments without signing out. You must still manually sign in to your CRM system from the Sales Copilot Outlook experience in the two following cases. If you're using Dynamics and have signed out from your CRM from Sales Copilot, or if you're using Salesforce CRM. We also have an improved discovery of the Sales Copilot experience. So to ensure that users who have had Sales Copilot installed for them will discover the app in the flow of work, we have now introduced actionable message banners. These are displayed for incoming emails, which meet the following criteria, have come from an external domain, and this is based on the two from and CC lines. We are showing the banners on email red, and we are limiting this to a few emails per day per user. Displaying the banner is controlled by a flag that's available in the Microsoft 365 Admin Center for the Sales Copilot app. Next is an improved first run experience for the new Sales Copilot users. With the new capability of auto sign in, we see that sellers quickly experience the value of Sales Copilot with minimal setup barriers. Now, this streamlined approach does increase the need for a basic first run experience and learn module so that users can be familiar with the product and its functionality. We have now improved the first run experience for new users by adding links to public video content and also the new learn module content for sellers. Next, we are now showing application diagnostics in the Outlook side pane. So we know that when developers are working on issues with customers, generally they have to dig hard with many back and forth emails to get session ID and other metadata. We have added an easy to find set of diagnostics metadata showing the session ID, client versus server version, and more, that the users can easily copy and they can send to support when they are facing a particular issue with Sales Copilot. This metadata will also allow users to self-serve some common problems that we will be able to document for the specific version of the apps or Sales Copilot that they would be running. We have also improved the search experience for polymorphic lookup fields. So we are now allowing sellers to filter the search results based on the entity type. So for example, the customer on the contact form can be filtered based on account or contact type. The application will also remember the filter that was chosen by the sellers across sessions on the same device so that the sellers will see the filter applied by default in subsequent uses. In the future releases, we will also be expanding the enhanced filtering by entity type also for the connected record search. Next, an improvement exclusively for our Salesforce customers. So before the August release, Sales Copilot would always save the Outlook emails as Salesforce email message records, and it will also require for the enhanced email feature to be turned on. So customers that did not have this feature enabled could not use the save to CRM feature. With the August update, we are changing this and we are supporting saving emails to Salesforce, and those emails get saved as Salesforce tasks. If this is a feature that you would want to enable for your organization, so it has the email turned off and Outlook email saved as Salesforce tasks, please make sure that you reach out to Microsoft support. We are exploring ways to make this a self-serve configuration in the Sales Copilot settings. Next, sellers can save draft emails while they are in composed mode from Outlook. So before the August release, sellers had to first send the email and then go back and track it to the CRM system, and this introduced a good number of clicks for them. With the latest update, we are solving this, and sellers can simply mark the emails to be saved to CRM even while drafting them. The emails will be saved to the CRM system automatically after they get sent. Soon, we will be able to have the same capability for draft appointments as well. And now for the new capabilities available for administrators of Sales Copilot in Outlook and Teams. First, collab spaces got smarter. It will respect when an admin renames a CRM entity, and it will also respect if an admin creates or deletes the opportunity or account entities. This means that sellers can continue collaborating with collab spaces, all while respecting the customization set by their administrators. Administrators can now mark fields as mandatory only in the scope of Sales Copilot. Sales Copilot automatically detects the fields that are mandatory for an entity based on the field metadata from the CRM system. Through customer feedback, we understood that sellers do need a way to provide particular data points when creating and editing records in Sales Copilot, but not through other sales channels. Therefore, with the latest update, administrators can mark fields mandatory only in the scope of Sales Copilot, even if these fields would not be mandatory in the CRM system. We're enabling the Sales Copilot features by default for a particular category of customers. This would have to be new customers with Dynamics 365 as the CRM backend from North America and Europe, and only with the CRM residing in the same geography as their Azure Active Directory. Basically, the two flags that are available in the Sales Copilot app in Teams, the one for the generally available feature of Sales Copilot and the one for the preview features, will be set on by default for this category of customers. It's good to mention that the AI-generated content by Sales Copilot is just a suggestion, and it is the seller's responsibility to review and edit the suggested content to make sure that it's accurate and appropriate before sending it to their customers. Finally, for the Sales Copilot resources, there are many resources available for the different types of personas. For your global admin, we have the installation guide. For your CRM administrators, we have how to customize, configure Sales Copilot, as well as deep dive architecture documentation. For the sales persona, we have already how to use Sales Copilot in Outlook and Teams, very comprehensive, detailed documentation. We also have a new learning path for the seller persona. This learning path can be accessed through the first run experience, as well as through our public docs. I highly recommend reviewing this as it can augment your internal materials for your testing or training strategies. Thank you very much for listening. Hope you found it useful, and see you very soon in our next What's New in Sales Copilot video.